In this video, we are going to learn about differentiation of implicit function. In my previous video, already I have explained about implicit differentiation and I have solved few examples. You could find the link for that video is given in the description below. Here we are going to solve few more examples of implicit function. So let's get started. So first example, solve tan of xy equal to x. So here we have the trigonometric function, that is tan. So tan of xy equal to x. So first differential of tan x is secant square x, and differential of uv, that is product rule, u into v dash plus v into u dash. So we have to use these two differential formulas here. So first here we have to differentiate with respect to x. So first term, tan of xy. So tan x differentiation is secant square x. In the place of x, we have here xy. So we have to write this as secant square of xy. Okay, because here in the place of x, we have xy. So we have to write it as it is. So secant square of xy into, now we have to differentiate for this x into y term. Okay, so first tan x differentiation is secant square x. We have to differentiate xy. Okay, so for this we have to use product rule, u into v. So first term, u into v dash, that is x into v dash. V dash is nothing but y differentiation, that is dy by dx, plus v. V is nothing but y into u dash. U dash, that is x differentiation, that is 1, equal to this side, that is right hand side also we have x. So differential of x is 1. So now we have to multiply the terms inside, that is first term secant square of xy into x into dy by dx, that is we have to multiply with the first term. Next, plus we have to multiply with the second term, that is secant square of xy into y, because y into 1, that is nothing but y, equal to 1. So we want only dy by dx, so we have to take the second term to the other side. So this will become secant square of xy into x into dy by dx equal to, right hand side we have 1, we have to take this term to the other side, so it will become minus secant square of xy into y. So we want only dy by dx, right? So we have to write it as dy by dx equal to, so right hand side we have 1 minus, so this will become y into secant square of xy whole divided by, I'm going to take this term to the denominator, so it will become x into secant square of xy. So the value of dy by dx is 1 minus y into secant square of xy divided by x into secant square of xy. You could simplify this again. So this will become, so I'm just rewriting this term as two different terms. So first term is 1 divided by the denominator value, that is x into secant square of xy minus, and the second term is y into secant square of xy divided by x into secant square of xy. I just rewrite it as two different terms. In the second term, we have secant square of xy. So I'm going to cancel these two. So we have, actually we know the trigonometric formula, that is 1 by secant theta equal to cos theta. So in the place of 1 by this secant square of xy can be written as cos square of xy, because we know 1 by secant theta equal to cos theta. Here we have secant square of xy, so in the place of secant square of xy we have to write it as cos square of xy, that is theta value here is xy, so divided by, already we have x here, okay, that we have to write it as it is, minus here we have y divided by x, because secant square of xy is cancelled, so we have only y by x. So this can be written as cos square of xy minus y divided by, we have the same denominator, so we have to write it as whole divided by x. So this is the value of dy by dx. Next example, find dy by dx if sin y equal to y into cos 2y. So we have an implicit function. So we have to find dy by dx. So left hand side we have only one term, that is sin y, but right hand side we have two different terms, y and cos 2x. We have two terms. Okay. So first we have to write it as differentiating with respect to x. Okay, now we have to differentiate for the first term, sin y. Sin y differentiation is cos y, because sin x differential is cos x, we know. So sin y differentiation is cos y into y differentiation is dy by dx. Okay, equal to this term, that is right hand side, y into cos x. We have two different terms. So first term, that is assumed to be u, into second term is v. So formula for product rule is d by dx of uv equal to u into v dash plus v into u dash. So similarly here, first term u, that is y into v dash. V dash, that is cos 2x differentiation. What is cos x differentiation? Minus sin x. Okay, here cos 2x. So minus sin 2x into 2x differentiation is 2. Okay. Plus, what is the second term? V, that is cos 2x into u dash. U dash, that is nothing but y differentiation. So y differentiation is dy by dx. Okay, I repeat, first term sin y. Sin y differentiation is cos y into y differentiation is dy by dx equal to, here we have two different terms, y into cos 2x. So first term is y, assumed to be constant, and cos 2x differentiation is minus sin 2x into 2 plus cos 2x is constant into y differential is dy by dx. So this equation can be written as cos y into dy by dx. I am taking this term, that is cos 2x into dy by dx, to the other side. So it will become minus cos 2x into dy by dx equal to, this side we have the remaining value. Here we have 2y and we have minus here. So this can be written as minus 2y into sin 2x. So we want only dy by dx. So in these two terms we have to take dy by dx common. So we have first term cos y minus second term cos 2x equal to right hand side we have 2y sin 2x. So dy by dx equal to minus 2y sin 2x divided by, we have to take this term to the other side, so it will become cos y minus cos 2x. So the answer is minus 2y into sin 2x divided by cos y minus cos 2x. Next example, solve e power x minus sin y equal to x. So we have to differentiate with respect to x. So first term e power x. E power x differentiation is e power x minus, we have sin y. Sin y differentiation is cos y into y differentiation is dy by dx equal to, right hand side we have x. X differentiation is 1, because we are differentiating with respect to x. So differential of x is 1. So this equation can be written as first term e power x. I am taking this 1 to the other side, so it will become minus 1 equal to, I am taking this minus term to the right hand side. So that is cos y into dy by dx. So what is dy by dx value? That is e power x minus 1 divided by cos y. So we have e power x minus 1. I am taking this cos y to the other side, so it will become e power x minus 1 divided by cos y. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video useful, please subscribe to my channel and click on like button. And for further notification, please hit the bell icon. Thank you.